ILS approach and use landing departing runway 23. Approach final approach course transit Cobalt Class Delta Airspace. Advise on initial contact, you have information in November. Mars Center Airport 8 is information November time 1445 Zulu weather. Wind calm, visibility 10. Sky condition scattered, 25,000. Temperature 22, dew point 14. Altimeter 3024. ILS approach and use landing departing runway 23. Approach final approach course transit Cobalt Class Delta Airspace. Advise on initial contact, you have information in November.
Okay. Morris on ground, take it.
That's Archer 598 Alpha at signature.
You got the
anus?
I mean the altimeter?
Yes. Okay. 3024.
598 Alpha, Morris down ground, runway 23, taxi via Alpha, cross runway 31.
23 via Alpha, cross runway 31, 598 Alpha.
I gotta get used to these radios here.
Whiskey Papa's ready for
departure. Well, my recommendation to you is that as soon as you get the altimeter, put it in.
The box, 23 Whiskey Papa.
So 3024.
Right. Well, that's not your primary interest. Your primary interest is the altimeter.
Oh, right? Sorry. Yeah, I'm looking at radios.
So if you had inadvertently, let's say, had this misset, something like that, okay?
My altitude would be off.
And then you climb out, and you're at 2,500 feet, according to this. You're actually in the Bravo. You get a violation.
Yeah, okay.
So, especially around here, altimeter setting is critical. Always set it as soon as you get it.
Okay. 3024.
Here's a Whiskey Papa Hotel, runway 23.
All right, then you can put it in the GPS. That's secondary, using these knobs over here. No, just the inner knob.
This one?
The inner. The little one, oh. The inside one. Then just press enter, right there. Now, before you go any further, I think we talked about this last time. When this comes on, you want to confirm that this says 34.5 nautical miles. That's by default.
Right.
It's the same in all the airplanes. And the electronic CDI, course deviation indicator needle?
Yes.
This is an electronic version of this guy. Should be half scale to the right. And it is. Now, it should also be half scale to the right on the HSI over here. But it's not. And the reason is because this needle is driven either by the nav receiver, the VOR receiver, or it's driven by the GPS, and you select which of these two boxes drives that needle with this button. So now the VOR receiver is driving it, and now the GPS receiver is driving it.
Okay.
So that won't be half scale to the right unless you tell the GPS to be driving it. So press that button.
Then I'm on GPS.
Right, now it's half scale to the right.
Yeah.
And then the last thing you check is this says OBS 131, that should be reading where that course selection arrow is set. Looks pretty
Mars
good, right?
Tower 313 Delta Tango at Gulf of the West side.
Yeah, so turn that left knob to some other heading,
Delta Tango,
any heading, and see whether that's reflected over here.
Can I set the brake?
Yeah.
Behind the Archer Alpha Bravo, cross.
Just don't trust it.
Delta Tango.
Okay. Always be watching outside.
Yep.
So now that says OBS 74, that's pretty close to where it's set, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You're good. The RMI, ignore.
Okay.
So you're good. So now you can safely press enter for okay. And now you're checking the date, the time. That all looks good.
Time's off. Oh, that's Central Daylight Time.
Yeah, we're going to have to change that.
I mean, right. On New York time, Eastern Coast time, it's right.
Yeah.
Central Daylight Time.
We're going to have to change that. All right, but you can press OK now. Now you're checking the expiration of the database next. Expires 12 October, so we're good there. There we go.
Okay, I need to reset this.
No.
No.
That's automatically set.
Oh, okay. Oh,
no.
So this. Okay.
It's like the other airplane. Happens automatically. There's nothing. There's nothing to set.
Okay.
Okay. And up here, there's nothing to look at here. There are no expirations, there's nothing. So just keep pressing this soft key. Soft keys are buttons where their function changes depending on what screen shows up here. So right now, this is the OK button. Later on, it can change to something else.
Okay.
So just keep pressing OK until you get to the moving map. There you go. Then you're done with that.
Okay.
Tie down with November, we're ready to taxi.
Cox 792, Mike Delta, Morris, down ground, runway 23, taxi via Bravo Alpha, cross runway 31.
All right, Bravo Alpha, cross 31, Mike Delta. That's it.
Wow, okay.
As far as the taxiway markings are concerned, the taxiway markings show have a black background and a yellow letter that shows you the taxiway you're on.
Okay.
So when you look on the left up here, as we come up on that, you'll see a black background that means you're on Bravo.
Okay. So I'm going to turn left on it, Alpha.
Mike Devin will hold short of Alpha. So he wants us to hold short of Alpha, so you keep on going. Alpha is the crossing taxiway, you see
yep.
the A pointing
yep.
both
yep.
ways?
Yep.
So when you get a little closer, you're going to see a dashed line up here.
Yep.
That's the beginning of Alpha, so you're going to stop before we get there.
Okay.
Now it's always important to be listening up for changes like that, very common here. Yeah, right about here is fine. Left at 23 was
open. Mike Delta, cross runway 31 at Alpha.
Alright, cross 31 at Alpha, Mike Delta.
We're getting used to these. Oh, so we can cross this runway now?
Yeah, he cleared us across.
Oh, okay.
He said cross 31.
Yes, alright.
Now, if he had said hold true to 31, you're required to read that back. You're clear to the right. Always check right and left of the same way as if you're driving through an intersection on the street.
Yes.
I was almost T-boned here by an airplane once.
Ah.
I've been cleared across, we're good to go. I looked to the right, there was an airplane on rollout, and they'd forgotten about him.
Oh, wow.
They didn't tell me to stop. I would not be here right now if I hadn't looked.
Wow.
So the point being is that they're in that tower to separate airplanes, but they're not infallible.
This is the first time I've done this.
Done what?
Taken off from a towered airport.
Oh, it is the first time?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, we landed at a towered airport when I was in training.
Right.
But we didn't do all this.
Oh. All right. So the run-up area is over there.
Okay. Which direction?
So kind of turn left, go across that dashed line you see. That's it. Then go to the far end. That leaves room on this end for other airplanes who might be following us. Now you have to turn that sharply. Just head to that corner over there.
And turn and face with my...
Just face that way.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to get that close to the edge, because then your wingtip is hanging over the edge, and there's something out there, you might ding it, but that's fine. Right about here, that's perfect. Perfect.
Okay.
Oof.
That was, gosh, I don't know why I'm so, All right. Door's locked. Flight controls. Okay. Okay.
Now, when you do this, don't forget you're checking free and correct, right? So you want to be sure that the controls move freely, all the way forward, all the way back, right and left. The correct part is also critical. So, do it or like that. Which way should that aileron be going?
That should be up.
Right, thumbs up. Good.
Yep, I remember that.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
You can taxi up to the hold line. I'll call them for you.
Okay. Just Tug 1 cross Lima.
18 Tug. You can cross Lima taxiway.
Alright, you ready?
Yep.
Okay, alright, so we're on that tower, right? Okay.
Cool. We're on ground.
Good catch. Alright, so put it on that COM 1.
022, dew point.
Nope.
Oh.
Different transmitter.
023, thanks.
There you go.
Marston Tower, good morning. Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta, ready to depart. Depart to 23, we will be westbound.
175 out Foxtrot, previous cold Dakota traffic is now at your 12 to 1 o'clock and 2 miles, 1,300.
Yeah, negative contact right now, 5 out Foxtrot.
Dakota 33796, previous cold traffic 12 to 1 o'clock, 2 miles, 1,200.
796, still looking.
796 for now, continue runway heading.
Okay. 796 has the traffic in sight.
Dakota 796, Roger, thank you.
Got busy.
5 out Foxtrot, that traffic has you in sight, passing off of your 2 o'clock in a mile.
This is where you have to kind of wait for them to do.
792, Mike Delta, Morristown Tower, altimeter 3023, wind 2507, runway 23 cleared for takeoff, westbound departure approved, traffic 2 miles south of the field, southwest of the field, entering the right downwind is a Cessna.
All right, roger that. Cleared for departure, takeoff, we will be looking for the traffic, Mike.
So do I do a roll, or do I do a full stop?
No, it's always better to stop. Now, as you taxi onto the runway, you want to do a lights, action, camera thing. So at this point, your strobes should be turned on.
Yep.
You're on a runway.
Beacons on.
All right, strobes.
Strobes on, okay.
Okay. Any other action items? Fuel, fuel's on both. Emergency fuel is in. We're full rich. Flaps are up. And we're on altitude squawk. So I would just...
6 Charlie's here. Contact call tower 119.8. Have a good day.
819.8. Have a great day.
Ready?
You can go. Got to get right on that center line. Back pressure, a little rotation. Good.
Morristown Tower, November 175, Alpha Foxtrot, out of right midfield for runway 23. Looking like full stop.
November 5, Alpha Foxtrot, wind 230 at 11, runway 23, clear to land.
23, clear to land, 75, Alpha Foxtrot.
Target after hand, Archer 728 Alpha, hold short runway 23 at Alpha, ready for takeoff for VFR to Southwest.
Archer 728 Alpha, Morristown Tower, altimeter 3023, runway 23 clear for takeoff on course, wind 210 at Niner.
23 clear for takeoff on course, 728 Alpha.
Pretty easy, huh?
Yeah.
Code 796, frequency change approved, have a good day.
Alright, you can have... You can actually turn to your own course heading now, Dan. So here, see what it says here? Desired track is 273.
Yes.
Your actual track is 232. So just turn to about heading at 273. Then it's never a bad idea to do this. And then just keep that needle centered. And we're going to climb to 2,500 for now.
I went too far.
Actually not, because you want to get that needle centered, so you want to fly towards that CDI a little bit.
Okay.
Not critical right now, but that's it, that heading is good.
2,500, correct?
Affirm. So life is good, right?
I'm getting there, man.
Yeah, just work at keeping those wings level. A little earlier, smaller input, so the wind doesn't knock you around so much. There you go. Now your desired track is 273, our track is 304.
Northbound
so
tower 313 Delta Tango,
you want to turn back to the
runway
left.
23 right turn out, northwest departure.
Tango 313 Delta Tango, Morristown Tower, roger, hold short runway 23.
Holding short 233 Delta Tango.
November 7902 Mike Delta, frequency change approved, have a good day.
Roger, see you later, Mike Delta.
So typically when you get close to the edge of their airspace, like 5 miles, they'll say, they sometimes say that, sometimes not.
Okay.
So if you want to be, if you want to change frequency to something else, they don't expect to be talking to you anymore, so you, they'll let you change frequencies.
They let you off?
Yeah, they don't, but again, very often they won't tell you that. They just, they just let you go.
Number 5 Alpha Foxtrot, contact ground.
All right, so we're on cruise now. We're flying at full rich. So let's lean the engine out a little bit. Get by turning the knob. Just turn the knob counterclockwise. And you want to see that EGT needle start to come up.
That's all it is, just turning.
Yeah,
oh,
keep going.
Okay.
Keep going. You'll see it start to move. Well, at the same time, obviously, you're flying the airplane.
Number 728 Alpha, frequency change approved.
Staying on course. All right, I think for now that's okay. There are ways to do it more precisely, but I think that's good enough for now.
Okay.
We can use, we can decrease our fuel consumption by almost half by doing that. You know, keep in mind that ultimately you are paying for the gas.
Yeah.
So it's to your, it's to your benefit to lean the engine. All right, the weather in Allentown is, what is 190 at 5. All right.
Oh, that's cool.
Which means that, probably using 2-4. Now we'll confirm that with the ATIS when we get a little closer. But this is when I get through the GPS.
Oh, wow.
And all that. That shows the wind in relationship to the runways.
Wow. Okay. That's really cool. What is that app?
This is called Wing X.
Oh, wow.
But here's there's the METAR. This is from the ADS-B system. The wind is 190 at 5, 10 mile visibility.
Whoa.
All right, so just watch your heading. You're looking for 273. Yeah, so you're not far off, but... All right, so, you know, since we're not flying that far, it's not a bad time to start thinking about getting things like the ATIS.
Vega 3 Delta Tango, frequency change proof. Have a good day.
Which you should have already pretty much
frequency
written down and memorized, right?
126.975.
Yeah, so why don't you put it in and we'll start to listen to see what's going on there.
Valley International Airport Information, Tango 145.
Oh.
I'll bet you they're changing the ATIS right now.
Does it seem bumpy up here?
A little bit. Pretty minimal.
All right,
so why don't you put it 119.65 over here, because we're going to be needing that for approach control. All right, but don't just tune it in, flip-flop it so it's ready to go. There you go. Let's just see what's happening there. All right, so we're below 3,000 feet. We're not going to climb. And, whoa, 119.65 is the correct frequency.
That's 899 or tower 1201.
Wow.
All right, 899.
Yeah, they're recording a new ATIS. That's why it's, we're not hearing anything. So right now we're listening to approach control. Obviously not a whole lot going on right this second.
So how do you, your destination is 28 miles out?
Yeah, 28.4, yeah. So we're going to have to call them, you know, pretty soon. I'm waiting for the new ATIS to come up. They're obviously recording a new one.
Oh.
Because it stopped right in the middle of the previous one, and that usually...
Leave LA National Airport Information, Unit 4.5.
There you go.
5.4,
Tango, visibility 10, ceiling 5,000, approach. Tango, good morning.
Temperature 3021. Visual approach runway 24 in use. Notice is terminal on VOR out of service. Approaches multiple runways in use. Use caution for activity in the vicinity of Allentown Airport. Advise initial contact, give information uniform.
See, it happened Tango a second ago.
National Airport Information Uniform 1551 Zulu, wind 210 at 7, visibility 10, ceiling 5,000 broken, temperature 24, 2.14, altimeter 3021. Visual approach runway 24 in use.
3021?
Chairman Allentown, VOR out of service.
Allentown, 8 Delta Charlie request.
7-8
Delta Charlie, Allentown. You've been giving me a hands-off?
Contact
you. Yes, they actually just took it. So 8 Delta Charlie, contact Redding, 125.15. Good day. Thank you, sir. Good day.
You doing all right?
And did you get the frequency?
I'm just...
125.15.
I'm intense right now. Sorry.
You got it. See ya.
I'm trying to stay so focused.
All right, so we've got approach tuned in, okay?
Yep.
Downtown approach, small 100, Romeo Victor.
I mean, this is
Victor,
so cool.
Level at
so cool.
Small 100, Romeo Victor, Allentown approach, ident.
And we're going to put in Allentown Tower in standby because we'll be needing that. So put it right down here because it will just flip up.
Small 0, Romeo Victor, radar contact.
120.5.
Maintain 3,000. And how long would you like to hold?
120.5.
Oh.
0 Romeo Victor, like one circuit to hold.
Oh.
All 0 Romeo Victor, hold northwest of Lizzie as published. Maintain 3,000. Expect further clearance 1615. Time 1557¾.
Time. Can you repeat time now?
Affirmative. The time now is 1557. It's 1558 now. And your EFC is 1615, 15 minutes from now.
Time now 1615.
Come on, Eddie. All 0 Romeo Victor, affirmative. 1615, and maintain 3,000 in the hold, and just advise once you're established what your intentions are after.
Romeo Victor, will advise.
Allentown approach, good morning. Skyhawk 7902, Mike Delta is about 23 to the east with Allentown uniform.
Skyhawk 7902, Mike Delta, Allentown approach, good morning. Allentown altimeter 3021.
3021, and we will be landing at Allentown, thank you.
November 2, Mike Delta, squawk 0453.
0543, Mike Delta.
And I might have transposed them there. 0453.
0453. I think maybe I did that thing.
I did?
November 8, 3 Tango. Would you like an RNAV 31 to be
able
to...
No, he just said squawking. He didn't say I did.
I back to you for the approach.
Affirmative, 83 Tango. RNAV 31 after the RNAV 24.
Yep, and then you can either do an ILS 13 or an ILS 24. That'll probably be about the same flying distance, but the RNAV 31 saves you about 20 miles.
Excellent, thank you,
83
Tango.
Roger, you can expect vectors, RNAV runway 31, final approach course, maintain 3,000.
This is real flying, baby.
Yeah, it is.
Expect vectors to the RNAV 31, maintain 3,000.
Yeah, he's doing practice instrument approaches.
Skyhawk 2 Mike Delta, radar contact 7 miles southwest of Broadway, VOR at 2,600, make straight in runway 24, advise Allentown Airport site.
Roger that, we'll look for the straight into 24, we'll advise airport site, Mike Delta.
All right, so it's going to be straight in for 24.
Okay.
So as soon as we see the airport, and we're still 21 miles out, so we won't be able to see it very readily just yet. And we've got the tower frequency ready to go, so when he tells us to switch over to tower, we can just flip-flop it, and it would be also a good idea to get in the ground control frequency, which we're going to need once we land.
121.9.
So you can put that in over there. Because we're
Skyhawk 2 Mike Delta, maintain 2,500. Traffic 11 o'clock, 5 miles, holding at 3,000 mall.
Hi, Roger. We will maintain 2,500. We'll be looking for the wall.
Mall 0 Romeo Victor, traffic 3 o'clock, 5 miles westbound, 2,500 Cessna.
0 Romeo Victor, we're looking, sir.
Delta 2 Mike Delta, turn right heading 330 for your sequence.
Okay, you're right to 330 Mike Delta.
So there you go, you got a vector.
Cherokee 83 Tango, turn left heading 040.
Left 040, 83 Tango.
That's cool.
0 Romeo Victor, the traffic previously issued is now.
Yeah, just try to maintain 2,500 feet as best you can.
0 Romeo Victor has the traffic, sir.
November 2 Mike Delta, the mall is no factor off your left wing, but as you turn north down there, they're going to stay behind you.
Roger, thanks, Mike Delta.
So if you were on an instrument flight plan, this is exactly what would be going on, except you might be in the clouds right now.
That's cool.
Cherokee 83 Tango, 5 miles from Behem, turn left heading 330, maintain 3,000 till established final approach course, cleared RNAV runway 31 approach.
Left 330, maintain 3,000 till established, cleared for the RNAV 31 approach, 83 Tango.
So we're only about 1,000 feet above our pattern altitude, so.
Delta 2 Mike Delta, thanks, proceed inbound for 24.
Roger that, we will proceed inbound on 24.
All right, you can turn towards the airport, and you can start a slow descent now.
Do I start my descent?
Yeah.
Man, I'm just questioning everything.
Skyhawk 2 Mike Delta, contact tower 120.5.
1205, thanks.
Just turn right slightly, Dan. See, it's the airport's over there.
Oh, okay.
Allentown Tower, good morning. Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta is about 9 out, straight in runway 24.
792 Mike Delta, Allentown Tower, wind 240 at 10, runway 24, clear to land.
Clear to land 24, Mike Delta.
Right there.
That's your runway right there, see
yep.
it?
Yep.
All right, so you can just set the airplane up for landing as you normally do now. So let's do a quick pre-landing checklist. So full rich. There you go. All right, fuel's on both, flaps as you feel you need. A little faster, you might want to start to slow down now.
Niner has the traffic on final for 3-1.
8-9-9-9, roger, turn downwind.
Turn downwind, 8-9-9-9.
And if you look at your HSI, we're just confirming we're on 2-4. We have the proper,
8-9-9-9, just
we have
so
the proper
know,
heading, right?
Two more aircraft that I'm worried
yes.
about here, so I may have to do more aerobatics with you, right? Just enter the downwind and I'll let you know how it looks, right?
8-9-9-9, roger.
I'm fast.
Well, slow down.
3 Tango going this.
Tango Roger, thank you. Fly runway heading, maintain VFR 3000.
Reduce the power, it's the best way to
runway
do it.
Runway heading 3000, 83 Tango.
You can start to put a little back pressure on the controls, that way you're not descending quite as fast. You'll see the...
Put flaps in?
Well, what would you normally be doing? Just fly this the way you would normally land, I would say, absolutely. You're looking for, you get a little closer, maybe 80 knots now. Watch it. If you look at the VASI on the left, you're getting low, so add some power.
Hey, Cessna 258-99er, look for Skyhawk traffic currently on a 2 mile final for runway 24. That'll be your traffic to follow.
Looking for the traffic, 899er.
Hey, Cessna 899er, disregard that, make one right 360 back to the downwind. You'll be number two following regional jet on the opposite base.
Okay, right 360
so
to downwind 899er.
Well, keep your speed up for now, dude.
Hello, tower AC5104 is right base for 24.
AC5104 Allentown Tower number 2 right, following
so
Skyhawk
the,
1 mile final.
Look at the VASI on the left, we're starting to get back up onto the glide slope. It's one white light, right?
Yep.
And three red, so it's just ever so slightly low, but this is fine. Alright, I would start to slow down now because we're almost at cruise airspeed. So get the, there, now we're good. Two white, two red. About to reduce power. There you go. Let's get down to about 80 knots. This is really fast.
Hey, Cessna 8-9-9-er, as you rejoin the downwind, look for regional jets, regional 700 from the opposite base on the final. That'll be your traffic to follow.
8-9-9-er, we'll go.
All right, looking good. I'm looking for about 70 knots now, Dan. Yeah, nice flare.
25899 has traffic in sight.
Nice.
I'm sorry, 8-9-9-er, you said you have the regional?
Yes, I have traffic in sight, 8-9-9-er.
8-9-9-er, roger, caution, wake turbulence, regional 700 on 2 mile final, follow that traffic number 2, wind 220 at 10, runway 24 cleared for the option.
Follow traffic, runway 24 clear for the option.
Let's keep our speed up so we get off the runway.
Mike Delta, exit taxiway Bravo and contact ground 121.9-er without delay, please, regional jet 1.5 mile final behind you.
Roger, we'll keep it moving, thanks.
A quick fire at 2 miles from the end of the runway, some serious bird activity.
AC, roger that. Cessna 8-9-9-er, you copy that? Report 2 mile final, bird activity not visible from the tower.
8-9-9-er, roger.
You did it.
Yeah. Yeah, it wasn't a bad landing.
Nice landing.
Where am I going? Which way do I go? To the right?
Just hold for a second. Ground 792 Mike Delta is on Bravo. We're going to just taxi to transient parking for a short time, then we'll be taking off again.
All right, Skyhawk 790 Mike, correction, 792 Mike Delta, are you ready to taxi the hangar?
Yeah, affirm.
And Skyhawk 2 Mike Delta, taxi to the ramp via Bravo, right turn Bravo 3, cross runway 31 at Bravo 3.
Okay, Bravo, Bravo 3, and cross 31, thank you.
AC 5104 is clear at Juliet, going to gate 9.
AC 5104, Allentown ground, taxi
to the
ramp.
So we have to look for Bravo 3.
Alpha, cross runway 31 at Alpha.
Alpha, cross 31, AC 5104.
See, I screwed up on the which radio. Here I'm lecturing you to be sure you're on the right frequent right radio, and I screwed it up.
That actually makes me feel better.
So there's Bravo 4, so we're going to go past that to Bravo 3. See, this is where all the big boys go over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, just maybe. Yeah, kind of pull over there, maybe the other side of that Duchess or whatever it is, then we can shut it down for a couple minutes. Yeah, just turn left now. You don't have to go too far.
Got this Lear getting ready to, or Citation, whatever it is, getting ready to. We're not in his way, are we?
I don't think he's going anywhere.
Oh, a couple pilots in there.
Who knows? All right, so anyway.
Shut her down?
Yeah, you might as well. But follow your shutdown checklist. Check, check.
There it is, there, okay. So now we go to clearance, right?
Yeah, well first, before you start bucking on the radio, let's get everything set to go here.
Oh, okay.
Allentown clearance, good afternoon. Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta is in Hangar 8. We're going to be a VFR departure at Northeast. We have uniform.
Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta, what's your destination and on course altitude?
We'll be 3,500. Destination is Morristown, Mike Uniform.
Number 2 Mike Delta, stand by.
In order to get us into and out of or through the Charlie, we need to have some sort of a clearance.
Okay.
And you can't get that direct from the ground controller.
Number 2 Mike Delta, maintain VFR 3000 until advised departure frequency 124.45, squawk 0475.
Okay, Mike Delta will maintain free until advised departure 124.45, and we will squawk 0476, I think you said.
Number 2 Mike Delta, squawk 0475, rest readback correct.
Right, got it. 0475, thanks. Allentown ground, good afternoon. Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta. We're at Hangar 8, and we are ready to taxi for runway 24 departure.
Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta, Allentown ground, runway 24, taxi to Juliet Alpha, hold short, runway 31.
All right, Juliet Alpha and hold short 31, Mike Delta.
All right, so you know where to go?
I think so.
Okay.
Juliet Alpha, hold short at 31.
Allentown ground, Cessna, Niner 4577, holding short, heading to Hangar 7.
Cessna, Niner 4577, Allentown ground, taxi Alpha, Bravo 3, crossway 31 at Bravo 3.
Okay, sounds like he's half asleep, doesn't he?
Yeah, it does.
We're on 24 Alpha 3, 577.
577, yeah, make the right turn there onto Alpha, then left Bravo, and another right onto Bravo 3 to crossway 31 at Bravo 3, and head in the back way to Hangar 7. I have another aircraft coming out.
Gotcha. Alpha, Bravo 3, Hangar 7.
Alright, so here's Alpha coming up, and we have runway 24 is down that way, so you'll make a right, but they want you to hold short of 31 here, correct?
Yes. Should I turn the strobe on?
No. Okay. That's only when you go into a runway.
Okay.
If you don't want to do all that, you can just head on, you know, make a small left into onto Bravo there to come back onto Alpha once that aircraft passed you. It's going to be in opposite direction, it says in there.
Roger that. We can just do the Bravo 3.
Well, I got an airplane fake, right?
Thank you, though.
Okay, yeah, he's going
to
be turning.
They're talking to each other. You just stop here.
Number 2 Mike Delta, crossway 31 and out.
Cross 31 Mike Delta, thanks.
All right, so all we're going to do is just taxi way to the end. The runway is just to our left here. Right?
Yep.
Okay. Pretty easy, right?
Yeah. That was so cool. Just simple stuff.
Order there. That way you're out of everybody's way. If a big jet comes behind us, we won't be blocking them.
To do a run-up?
Yeah.
Okay, so we do a run-up each time?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Anytime you shut the engine down.
Okay.
It's not a bad idea. Admittedly, not everybody does it. But why the heck not? It just takes a second, right?
Yep. Well, that feels good.
You know, I just don't think to do it. I forget that we have it.
All right, we got the comm set, we got the GPS set, we got the nav set, autopilot's off, flaps at zero, brakes off, transponder code set, and lights. Do I now change the lights to strobe?
No, the strobes go on as you cross onto the runway. The reason being, that. Let's say this is a night flight.
Yeah.
Pitch black out here. You got an airplane right off your left wingtip.
Yeah.
You turn your strobes on now. Now you're flashing in his eyes or her eyes. And
okay.
You know, just not a neighborly thing to do. There's no reason to have the strobes on here.
Right.
So the lights action camera business is something you do as you're getting onto the runway. So the lights are, if it's a busy enough airport, you know, landing lights, not a bad idea. Strobes for sure. If it's a night flight,
okay.
Then the nav lights. Any other action items, they're not much here, but just check fuels on both. Emergency fuel selector is in.
Yep.
Trim is set, flaps are up, full rich, and camera is the transponder. So we're on altitude squawk, our code is good. And one more thing you can do, this is what the pros do, and it's a good practice. Set the runway heading.
Oh, okay.
Just to confirm you're on the proper runway
once
you turn to take off.
Okay.
Here, you can't possibly blow it, but there have been situations in low weather or nighttime where an airplane takes off on what they think, or a pilot takes off on what he or she thinks is the correct runway. Turns out it's just off by 20 degrees from some other runway. Turns out it's a closed runway, there's equipment on the runway, and it doesn't end nicely.
Well.
All right.
Okay, so now we need to go to ground? 121.9.
No, we're already on ground.
We're on ground.
We have to go to tower.
We'll go to tower right.
And just think about your clearance. We're going to climb to 3,000 and not going to make any altitude changes until cleared by them.
Right.
And when the tower tells us, all we have to do is switch over to, we're going to go to
COM2. Switch.
And when they tell us to contact departure, we'll just switch over. I'll do that for you just to, so you can hear how it sounds. And then we're on our way.
Okay.
Okay.
So we're on tower, 120.5.
Right.
On COM2.
Right. Good. Perfect. You got to wonder, looking around here today, why this place has a Charlie airspace. They haven't seen a single airplane take off or land.
Right.
Hardly since we've been here. All right. You can go ahead and call in. Well, I'll call. Am I going to call them for you?
Yeah. I'm going to listen.
Altown Tower, good afternoon. Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta is ready to go at 2-4.
Skyhawk 792 Mike Delta, Altown Tower, runway 2-4, fly runway heading, clear for takeoff.
All right, runway heading and clear for takeoff, Mike Delta, thanks. So that means you won't do any turns, you'll continue to fly.
Skyhawk 2 Mike Delta, traffic is a heavy Boeing 767 on a 6-mile final.
All right, roger, we will expedite, thank you. That would have been fun to sit here and watch it land. You want to?
2-4.
X-3302 Heavy, Allentown Tower, runway
24,
clear
to land 210 at Niner,
traffic
is assigned
departing.
Let's just go.
Okay. Shoot, I wasn't sure
what to
do. Just keep on going, don't stop.
Tower 181 Alpha is at Hangar 7, ready for...
Oh, you can stop, I mean, he's 6 miles out, just I wouldn't stop for two holes.
Tower 181 Alpha,
get set up, not a bad idea to stop, just get lined up, make sure you're good, then you can go.
Over to 181 Alpha.
Okay.
All right. Alright, a little back pressure, a little rotate. Beautiful.
Helicopter 31 Alpha, traffic is assessed on the departing runway 24, report him in sight.
Looking for about 75 knots.
31 Alpha, traffic in sight.
Nose up a little more.
Helicopter 31 Alpha, don't overfly the traffic. Pass behind him. Air taxi is approved. Traffic is a Boeing 767 Heavy on a 3-mile final.
Oh man, we should have
waited. With the Cessna, I got the traffic on final inside air taxi. Taxi with Charlie, want to do an Alpha.
Departure, good afternoon. 792 Mike Delta is 1,500 for 3,000.
Okay, 2 Mike Delta, downtown departure radar contact. Climbing your requested altitude, turn left heading 180.
Left at 180, and we'll be climbing to 3,500 Mike Delta.
325 contact, approach 119.65.
Hold your approach on 119.6.
If you get a chance there, look to your left, maybe you'll see the 767 landing. I got the airplane, mic control. Just touching down.
Yeah, I see him. Oh, man, that'd have been cool. Sorry, man, I thought I wasn't. They told us to go, and I'm like,
Well, we could have stopped, but, you know. All right, your airplane.
Oh.
You're going to climb to 3,500 and we'll go on course.
10 Alpha approach, this is 6494 Alpha.
Give us the nose down.
6494.
And then when we get to the edge of the Charlie, they'll just cut us loose. They might give us flight following so that New York approach keeps track of us closer to Morristown. We can either, if they do that, we'll stay with them. It'll give you the experience of having a flight following.
Yeah, I did flight following a couple times when I was in my training.
All right, good.
Which was cool.
Yeah. And in a busy airspace like this, it's not a bad thing to have, because they keep everybody separated a little bit better. You want any kind of an intro to the autopilot?
Say again?
You want an intro to the autopilot?
Sure.
All right, so we got the airplane all set up, trim, get it leaned out a bit, and then I'll show you what the autopilot, how the autopilot works.
196.
Now notice as I turn this counterclockwise, that EGT needle is going up.
Yeah.
You have to do it very slowly. I'll turn it counterclockwise some more. It may go up a little more. It did. All right?
Yep.
Counterclockwise a little more. Went up some more, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like right on that needle.
Counterclockwise a little more. At some point, it's going to start to go down slightly as I turn counterclockwise.
Center 585, Bravo with downtown approach. Downtown altimeter 3019er.
You can hear the engine.
Yeah, you see it going down now?
Yeah, yeah.
So now we're on the lean side of peak. It's a little too lean. So what I'm going to do is now go clockwise, and the needle will come back up again.
Airman 8 Tango, there's one aircraft about 2 miles out.
See it going up?
Yeah.
And I'm going to continue to turn it clockwise until it drops about one division.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Alan.
You'll see it start to come down.
09 Mike, level at 6.
That's right about there. That's about 20 degrees rich of peak. That's about a perfect setting for the...
Okay.
3019, Mike.
Okay. All right, mic control. All right, so we're going to set up the autopilot, okay? So first thing you're going to enable the autopilot. Technically speaking, the autopilot is always on. But right now, it's not enabled.
Okay.
But there's a light on here, which means that it's actually getting juice. So that's why I'm saying it's, technically it's on.
Okay.
Okay. So to enable it, you press the AP button, hold it for a second or two. Good, okay, good. Now right now, all the autopilot is doing is trying to keep the wings kind of level. That's really all it's doing.
Okay.
All right. You press the ALT button now, it'll hold our current altitude. You got ALT on.
Yep.
Put the heading bug on our current heading. Press the HDG button. So we have heading on, altitude on. It'll fly wherever the heading bug is. And it's going to hold 3,500.
Holy cow.
Now, we're a little bit right of our course, so turn the heading bug a little bit to the left. The airplane will turn to the left slightly. That's good, right about there is good.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Okay, I brought a couple of cold beers along.
Oh my gosh. That's fantastic. Oh, that's like unnerving. I want to have my hands on it. Oh my goodness. So this needle will come in when we're on this track.
You have a little bit of an intercept. If you want to get onto that line a little quicker, you can turn the heading bug a little further left.
1.5, all jumpers away.
Now, what you can also do, so right now it's only flying where you put the heading bug. You could also press nav, okay? Press the nav button. And now it says nav on.
Yeah.
So what the airplane is now going to do is going to turn to intercept that CDI needle.
2201 Quebec Kutau.
And then when the needle comes in.
800 verifier at 8,000, correct?
The arm will go off, the heading will go off, there was something being nav mode. So all it's going to do then is just fly your GPS course. So you can actually do it either way. You can fly just a heading mode or nav mode.
Wow. Oh.
Caravan 8 Tango, Sierra 1 Mooney, approximately 3 miles out to your northeast, northwest down to 6,000.
So is that 78?
At 6,000 out to the northeast.
That route 78?
Keep it close here to the airport.
Possibly? I don't know.
I'm not familiar with the roads around here.
Yeah, not yet.
Hey, New York approach, good afternoon. 782 Mike Delta, 3,500.
127 decimal.
This is New York approach?
Yeah. Just be sure you're not talking over anybody. Okay.
New York approach, 792 Mike Delta with you at 3,500.
792 Mike Delta, roger. Morristown altimeter 3020, pop is current.
Roger, we'll get the 86.
Over to that 170, contact approach 127.
So we could probably start to get the ATIS. We're 27 miles from Morristown.
Yeah, Omaha 40 traffic, no fact.
Omaha 40,
thank you. Yeah, 040.
So information pop up.
Landing 040 up to Fulberg.
They're landing 23.
Right. Now what you really want to do in that kind of a situation is not leave the frequency that way, but listen to the ATIS or the other radio. But we've already done it, so we're okay.
So don't I want to set up though for
if they
power?
If they wanted to call you, they would be able to reach you.
Oh, okay. So I want to...
New York, 7755 Hotel, we can cancel IFR.
5-5 Hotel, roger, IFR cancellation received. You can keep your squad photo if you want, you can turn me now, it's up to you.
They just want you to see something now.
The arm
is going, we're just in plain old nav mode and altitude mode.
Okay, and it's turning to...
And they'll keep that beetle center there.
Checking at 8.9.
We're 24 miles out of Allentown.
The JQ, we're at Zulu.
Do we need to contact Allentown then?
I'm
sorry. Morristown.
No, we're still 20 miles out.
At like 5 miles out, right?
Yeah. He'll tell us.
Okay.
Now, if you wanted the airplane to do it, what was the last altimeter? At
Allentown?
Well, what is it at Morristown?
I'll have to listen to ATS, ATIS again. It was 3021.
Skyhawk, 2 Mike Delta, start a VFR descent down to 2,500.
Roger, down to 2,500, Mike Delta. Okay, watch this. We're going to take it out of altitude.
4 minutes. It'll be 5 minutes or less. I'm hoping to have everything done.
Telling you to go down to 500 feet a minute.
Okay.
And I set 2,500 as our new altitude.
Yeah.
It'll go down to 2,500 and then level off.
New York 775 app
hotel. I would probably throttle back a little bit, Dan, because we're a little bumpy. We don't want to get into the yellow arc on the airspeed.
All right, app hotel out there, yeah.
So my Ford to verify your landing destination will be Newark, correct?
Affirmative, landing signature.
Exit to 623, contact approach on 127.6, 276.
2,500.
This New York approach?
Yeah.
Opposite 170, traffic 12 o'clock and 2 or 3 southeastbound. Mocina case 2,500. Additional traffic 1 o'clock and a mile northeastbound at 2,200.
Right, we're searching. We got a couple inside. Opposite 170.
Just have your own descent to 2,500.
New York, Christian, proceed right key line.
Correct key line, Papa Tango. 38433 requesting 3,500 feet altitude.
Okay, who is that with the request?
38433.
38433, call over to New York, 13275, that's the airspace now.
We'll call over, thank you. 38433.
Thank you.
New York RV, 168 Alpha Lima, leveling 4000.
November 168 Alpha Lima, New York approach, New York altimeter, 3019er, how you doing?
Very good, thanks.
Jet 623, traffic no factor, heading 060 to center maintain 3000.
3000, heading 060, we have a traffic inside 620.
Good.
New York approach, November 792, Mike Delta at 2500.
792, Mike Delta, New York approach, roger, revise Morris sound on site.
Yes. Roger, Morris sound on site.
No, no, you wanted you to tell when it was in sight. You just kind of said to him it wasn't safe.
4 Bravo Kilo 2 from Mondale, turn right heading 170, yes. Maintain 2000.
The proper response would have been Mike Delta.
Meaning
I will call you when Morris Town is in sight.
Can we say it again?
No, sorry. That made it sound like it was in sight.
Okay.
2.14, 19.30.
Alright, let's approach runway 23 in use.
Ray Golf Sierra, reduce speed now to 180 and the center maintain 2000.
1 to 180 upon reach, hold down 2000.
Thank you for your information, Papa.
All right, so it's Papa that's your...
Papa Jet 170, reduce speed, 180, turn right, direct on Bill.
180, right, turn direct on Bill, Papa Jet 170.
So we're being flight followed by New York approach.
Yeah. Yeah, they're responsible for all this airspace out here.
Okay. Okay.
Now, if you see a little deviation in your altitude, you really want to be at 2,500.
Yeah.
If you just press the down button, every time you press the down button now, it'll up or down, it'll change your altitude by 20 feet. So press that like four times.
Here's Kurt, Skylink, down, 5, 0, the down 6, button. Mike with you at 3,000.
That's it. Just leave it now. Yes. It'll make a small...
Golf Sierra, turn right.
It'll make a small adjustment.
110 for a Golf Sierra.
See it?
Yeah, yeah.
You gotta love it.
Charlie, yeah.
65 is 4000 with heading 040 with Zulu.
So they switched us off a couple of times. We changed frequencies a couple of times on New York approach. Okay.
Yeah, because they have various sectors.
Okay.
And they have different frequencies, different controllers for different pieces of airspace. And that is never the same. It changes depending on how busy they are, the runways of use, what direction the airplanes are coming from. So you never really know.
Okay.
You just do what they tell you to do. You do what they tell you to do.
So
basically it tracks that?
Yeah. Yeah, that is.
170 to center maintain 2000.
2000,
Option 170. Jet 623, proceed to back Dunville.
Back Dunville, 623.
Do all these flights?
Sierra 160, heading to join Teterboro Tower 19-5, bye-bye.
160, heading to join Teterboro inside, switch to tower, Acoff Sierra.
Thank you.
And approach, 2 Mike Delta has Morristown in sight.
2 Mike Delta, radar service terminated, keep the code, Morristown Tower 18.1, bye-bye.
Roger that, have a good one.
2. Trouble 865, heading 060 to center maintain 3000.
All right, so we can call Morristown now.
3000, Trouble 065.
Switch over to Morristown.
Somebody
here. Just go to...
Who's with?
Just tell them you're 10 West. With the information.
With Papa, right?
With Papa.
Morristown Towers. Skyhawk 792, Mike Delta with Papa. We're at 10 miles from the west.
Cessna 702, Mike Delta, Morristown Tower, altimeter 3019, report midfield, right downwind, runway 23.
Just say right downwind 2.
Right down 23, Mike Delta.
Alright, so we're about only 8 out now, so you can start a slow descent. So to take that out of autopilot, press that red button on top, right there. Now you're flying.
So I'm going to start my descent.
Yeah, start descent, right.
That's the airport.
Yeah.
At 1,500 feet.
Yeah, well, I would probably stop your, slow your descent. You don't want to be too low, too far from the airport.
Yeah.
whole idea of flying a pattern around a runway is to be close enough to the airport at low altitude so you can make it to the runway if you have some kind of a problem.
Yeah.
To get the pattern altitude miles from the airport really isn't a good idea.
Yeah. Should make my left yet?
No, you're really far out, but I would certainly start to slow down because we're at cruise airspeed still. Let's start to slow down to more of a pattern airspeed. So about, 2,000 RPM is fine. Just hold the speed there now. The airplane will... And then you can let it eat down now to 1,200 feet, which is pattern altitude. And usually there's the end of runway 13. See it there?
Yep.
All right, so just outside the end of that runway is a good place to be. So right about here is a good place for your downwind. And maintain 1,200. There you go.
Are we supposed to announce down?
I will. I'll do it for you. And let's go to flaps 10. Don't go below 1,200 yet. RPM. All right, you don't have to make any more power adjustments. Just keep it at 2,000. You're only at 1,900 RPM.
Go up.
And Marstown, 2 Mike Delta is right down wind 23.
Just 2 Mike Delta, wind 24010, gust 13, runway 23, clear to land.
Roger that, clear land, Mike Delta.
So we're beam the numbers, so you can bring the power back to about 1,500 RPM. Remember that setting? Just start a slow descent, maybe 500 feet a minute. Looking good. Then when the end of the runway is about 45 degrees off our tail.
Yep.
Not quite there yet. All right, you can start. I think you can start your turn now. They're looking for, maybe 75 knots out here. I would put in an additional notch of flaps because we're not all the way, just one more notch. 20. Now, right now we're flying level. You want to listen to those down?
5-3 kilo, frequency change approved.
Frequency change approved, 5-3 kilo.
Alright. Don't turn yet, huh? About 70 knots now, Dan. Pulling those up a little bit. Alright, start your turn about now. Close in, but it's going to work. All right, let's go last notch of flaps before you finish turning the final. All the way down, that's it. Maintain about 70 knots. A little fast, so those up a little bit, a little less power. Just look at this real quick, that's your glide slope. Or a little bit above it.
Oh, okay.
All right, you can start to eke out the power a little bit because we're still a little high, a little fast. Not below 65. Nose down, nose down, nose down. Now just hold the left wing down a little bit with a little right rudder. Okay, that's it. Speed is perfect. Okay. Power off and then a nice flare.